Story. In 2006, NASA announced they were going to try to track down any original high-resolution copies. The search team was headed by Richard Nafsger, a former NASA engineer who oversaw the original Apollo 11 broadcast, along with Stan Laborde, the man who designed the original Westinghouse lunar camera, and other key figures involved in the 1969 broadcast. In an article by Wired, the team described the process of hunting through 4 million boxes at the Washington National Record Center. These records are not organized, not digitized, and not efficiently cataloged. Thousands of boxes were destroyed by a sprinkler system. 140,000 tapes from the Apollo era were checked out and never returned. Some of the places that they were sent had their contents destroyed, erased, or simply degraded through bad storage.
Records clearly show that there's an inescapable conclusion that this team has reached, and that is that these 45 tapes were included in the several hundred thousand that were pulled out, recertified, degaussed, and put back into the network. The SlowScan recordings are no longer.
Yes, the original lost Apollo 11 tapes are most likely overwritten with outdated satellite imagery.
Fast forward to 2015, only a few weeks before Christmas, when NASA learns of an exciting discovery. Two massive computers and 325 magnetic data reels from the Apollo space flight era, which launched the first humans to the moon, were discovered in the basement of a deceased Pennsylvania man's home. The over 40-year-old relics from NASA's Goddard Space Flight Center and Jet Propulsion Laboratory had worn out, but they were still in serviceable condition. Except for their prior owner, no one knew what was on them. The antiques were given to the man's friend, who is a metal scrapper. If you only have one tape of the data and it's destroyed by a tape drive, demagnetized by a buffer, or has coffee spilled on it, says Larry Kellogg, a retired NASA systems engineer who worked with Pioneer 10 and Pioneer 11 equipment. As a result, it is usual practice to create several backup copies. A total of 215 reels were left unlabeled, owing to the fact that labels were usually removed before tapes were scratched or reused. NASA believes they are blank. Magnetic tape was an expensive recording medium at the time. Therefore, NASA regularly overwrote reels to save money. According to Keith Cowing, a former NASA space biologist and editor, as well as a NASA watcher, the labeled reels could have been copies of copies of copies. I'll bet they're not original with these many tapes, but it's unimportant, he said, since I heard someone has a collection of these missions' data. Many facts of the investigation remain foggy due to privacy exemptions, and the identities of all people involved, including the collector, have been redacted. The motherboard, on the other hand, confirmed that the tapes were later destroyed. According to NASA Goddard's Supply and Equipment Management Branch Office, all magnetic data tape reels were picked up by the agency recycler, Unicore, on the 9th of February 2016. GSFC received a certificate of destruction from the Unicore processing facility on June 9th, 2016, it stated. One NASA data user released thousands of tapes because he could not afford continued storage and was reluctant to raise the retention issue all the way up to the Goddard director, and authorized the destruction of every other carton of tapes in order to salvage some of them. When explaining why so much data had not been kept, NASA noted a lack of written agreements between itself and researchers, as well as insufficient procedures for the archiving of some data. Since then, the agency has partnered with the National Archives and Records Administration to implement a new records management system that strictly restricts what material can be deleted. NASA often auctioned off surplus items during the 1970s and 1980s. Technology got obsolete, funds ran out, or there simply wasn't enough room. Some objects are still in private collections today, while others were reused as scrap. Other times, staff and contractors took materials that would have been destroyed otherwise. This was very common during the Apollo era.